or my father. But we found out after the war, and now there's a lot of research being done, how my father came to visit us.
Yeah.
And it was like a miracle. He came and he said, I can see you on the weekends, but I have to work during the week to have a place to live. And, you know, be able to see you. So he worked at a retirement home, and again we visited all these places this trip, which was amazing. And what we found out is that he did an amazing journey to get to see us. He found out through the Jose where we were, and he joined the French resistance and who knows what else, but we have letters that he wrote to my mom, and my mom was trying to get us to come to England, because I'll tell you later she went to England, and they worked so hard in getting us back with them, but we didn't know that till we were older. So as far as my personality and behavior was, my parents didn't want me. And I became a very angry little girl. And I was anxious and didn't want to live. And just what I saw in the war with people, you know, getting killed and stuff, I said, why should I, you know, live here when they don't really want me? You know, and I don't have parents. So my sister was not as depressed as I was, and I guess she kept me going. Anyway, so we saw our father for a few weekends, and then we didn't see him anymore. And what happened was that the French person, not Jewish, knew that he was Jewish, and he denounced him to the local police, so that he could get his job. So sure enough, the police took him in, and then they, I don't know if I have shown that. Yeah, so where they put him is first at the local town, and then they shipped all of the Jews that they found to Drancy, which is just above Paris. And there, this huge building was opened by the Germans and run by French people, because there were people that would work for the Germans. That was their holding place till they got transported with the trains to Auschwitz, and my dad and his family, and my grandparents on my mother's side, they all died in different camps. It's sad to think that humanity can do such atrocities. And it took me a long time and a lot of work with different therapists and different modes of therapy to be in a place where, what can I do to do something good and not be in a negative, angry world? Because that didn't buy me anything. So anyway, after Majolier, we went down to Marseille because the Germans were coming into the chateau and looking, taking some of the older students and some of our teachers, and would take them away and kill them. So I was always in a younger group, my sister was in the middle group, and then they trucked us down to Marseille. Marseille was a harbor, and and there were ships leaving for America and Israel, and we were supposed to get out, but then the Germans invaded Marseille, so we had to hide again. So here we had this hope, oh good, they're going to get us out of here. And they had to hide us again, they took us back to a home, and then we had to, from there, yeah, they took us back to Montpellier, and then, these are some of the groups, by the way, that, that's my sister there. I mean, we don't have a circle there, but that's her group. And this was part of my group. Yeah, so anyway, we had to move on again. So the moving was to go from Marjolier to Tournon. Tournon, somebody said that there was a Catholic orphanage that was taking Jewish kids and hiding them. So we were like orphans because we didn't know where our parents were. So they took us in there, and I don't have too many pictures of that. I have, this is the group we were. And the Mother Superior and the young nun in between Renee and me was maybe 17. She was very young, and she took kind of, she liked Renee and me. It was a wonderful friendship. And later, after the war, when my husband and I went to Europe, he went to see her. So there's a lot of stories that I reconnected after the war.